In this video, we're going to talk about how to translate your WordPress site, how to add a language feature, and most importantly, the best SEO practices for multilingual sites. Let's go. Hey, it's Jack from RankMap, the one SEO plugin that powers millions of WordPress sites, and this channel is all about helping you grow your search traffic. So if you're new to us, subscribe. Now, first and foremost, this video is focused on the best SEO practices and not so much on the functions of any translation plugins. Sure, we'll be using some plugins like WPML and TranslatePress for some demonstration, but the key is to talk about the best practices you should follow. So even if you're not a WPML or TranslatePress user, stick around because it's going to be helpful to you. Now, before we start turning your WordPress site multilingual, we got to understand why we are doing it. Don't do it because it looks cool, but do it because you see a demand for it in Google Analytics. When you visit the analytics report and under the user attributes, check out its overview. And these are the main countries your site is serving. And if you click on the demographic details, you will expand more countries. When you see that your site is serving people in countries that are not native to the language of your site, for example, if the main language of your site is English, it serves countries like Bangladesh, India, Philippines, Pakistan, United States, Sri Lanka, and Canada, because English is widely known to the population in those countries. But for Vietnam, it depends if your site is targeting the younger generation or the older. If it is the older generation, then you will need to translate your site. But if you're targeting the younger generation, English is widely known to them. And for Indonesia and Brazil, English is not widely recognized in those countries. So you may have a good reason to turn your site multilingual. You can further confirm this when you visit the overview tab again and scroll down to the active user by language. Turning your WordPress site multilingual will benefit this group of people. Other than that, it will mainly be for business operations, like does marketing products to people in those countries make sense, both legally and financially? So if turning your website multilingual is in your favor, let's check out the best SEO practices. Every translated page on your site should have its own unique URL, and there are many ways to do it. One way is through top-level domains. For example, when you are in France and you visit Amazon, it will not be amazon.com but amazon.fr, which is a domain from the country. And if you are in Germany and you visit Amazon, it will be amazon.de. And if you're in the UK, it will be amazon.co.uk. You get the idea. Top-level domains provide a clear signal to search engines about the country the domain is targeting. But this option is mainly for larger corporations because it takes a lot of resources to maintain it, as each domain requires separate hosting and SEO efforts. So you may need to employ a lot of people to cross-manage different domains. If you are a small business owner, this may not be cost-effective and may be counterproductive. Another way is to use subdomains. Like if you are visiting Craigslist in Frankfurt, Germany, you will see the domain as frankfurt.craigslist.org. Or if you are visiting Craigslist from Paris, France, you will see the domain as paris.craigslist.org. Subdomains offer some separation of content while still benefiting from the main domain's authority. However, search engines may still treat your subdomain and your main domain as separate entities, plus managing multiple subdomains is yet another challenge. So the easiest solution for most WordPress sites is to have subdirectories or subfolders. For example, on rankmap.com, we have a language feature right at the bottom. If we switch it to German, you will see that the URL will be rankmap.com/de. If we switch it to Italian, you will see that it is rankmap.com/it. The same goes for the other languages. Subdirectories are relatively easy to manage and can consolidate authority since all content resides on the main domain. However, it may not provide as clear signals to search engines about target countries like top-level domains do. So you have to weigh what is more important to your business. Is cost going to be an issue? If it is, then subdirectories will be the solution. But if cost and logistics are not the issue, then top-level domains or subdomains will be a better solution. But the key is to have every translated page have its own unique URL. And if you're using the premium version of TranslatePress and WPML, these are done for you automatically. For example, I'm using the WPML plugin for this site, and we are in the post list. I want to translate this page. And as you can see, there is a plus sign under the language column. As I click on this, it will lead me to the WPML editor, where I can add my own translations. If you want to translate this automatically, you may have to purchase AI credits from WPML. So I'll take some time to translate this, And here we go. As I click on complete translation, and I will go back to the post list, I will find a translated version of the page in here. Let's visit the page. And it has a unique URL with the FR subdirectory. And this is as a result of one of the options during the setup phase. And since we have a unique URL, we should have it in the XML sitemap, right? So that search engines can easily find the translated page. Now, as you know, you can switch the language in RankMath, and each translated page has its own unique link. And if you visit our sitemap, where you just have to add sitemap.xml or sitemap_index.xml, you will see that in the page sitemap, you will find all the translated pages in this sitemap. And remember the page we have just translated? If we hover over RankMath SEO and select sitemap settings, if you don't see this option, you have to turn on the sitemap module through the dashboard. But anyway, let's go to the sitemap settings. And this is the link to your XML sitemap index, where all the different individual sitemaps are consolidated in one page. Let's visit it, go to the post sitemap, and you will see the French version of the page in the sitemap. This is done automatically. So WPML, TranslatePress, or all the other translation plugins will create a separate page for each translated page, and RankMath will automatically add it to the XML sitemap. We make you follow best SEO practices without you knowing. Now the big question is, wouldn't Google and other search engines view translated pages as a duplicate since the content is just translated and nothing new comes out of it? Well, that's why we need to implement Hreflang tags and proper canonical tags. For canonical tags, if you have multiple duplicated pages on your site, you just have to tell search engines that this is the original page by adding canonical tags pointing to the original page, and the search engines will only index this original page, and the rest of the duplicated page will not appear on the search results. And that's not what we want, right? We want our translated pages to rank on the search engines as well. So if we check out the page we have just translated, right click and view its page source, hit Ctrl F or Command F and search for Hreflang, and you will see the Hreflang tags being added to the page. It tells search engines that there are different language versions to the same page. This is the link to the English version. And this is the link to the French version. And then this is the link to the XDefault. And the XDefault attribute tells search engines that this is the default version to use. This Hreflang XDefault attribute is used in HTML to specify a default version of the web page that should be shown when a user's language or region preference does not match any of these other specified language versions. For this case, the English version happened to be the default version. So if I'm in China and the website does not have a Chinese version, the specified XDefault language page will be shown. If you are not using any translation plugins, then you will have to manually add this set of codes to the head section of your translated pages. But what about the canonical tags? How does RankMath deal with it? For those of you who have been using RankMath, whenever you create a new post or page, by default, the page will have a self-canonicalized tag. You can find this in the advanced settings of RankMath. The same is true for new pages created by the translation plugins. If you go to its page source, Ctrl F or Command F to find, and search for canonical, you will see that it points back to its own URL. This is according to the best SEO practice, because if you add canonical tags to the main version, which is the English version, the French version, which is the translated page, will not be indexed. So having translated pages self-canonicalized is best practice. Especially for the meta title and description, you should not just do a simple translation. You need to adapt the content to the cultural and linguistic nuances of the target market. For example, I'm trying to translate this page with the title, How to Make Beef Jerky. And this is the English version of the page. If I click on the RankMath tab and click on Edit Snippet, we will see the SEO or meta title here, which is represented by this. Now, if I copy this title and do a direct translate on Google, this is the translated text and it is not localized. Because based on my research, this is more localized. Because this referred to dried meat, which is a more localized concept than jerky, and it is more understandable to a French audience. And to be honest, I don't speak French, so if I'm wrong, please correct me. And if we do a search for this keyword in WordStream's free keyword research tool, we will see that there are people searching for this keyword every month. So do not just translate the content. If your target audience are locals, you have to localize your content and make it culturally relevant to them. Not only in the SEO title and description, but everything. Hire a professional translator if it fits your budget. You see, in TranslatePress, they have this automatic user language detection feature that comes with one of their add-ons, or under the WPML's languages tab, scroll near to the bottom, and you will see this browser language redirection option. This may seem like a good feature because when users land on your page, they will automatically be redirected to the appropriate language version of the page. But for search engines like Google, it has stated in the guidelines that we as site owners should avoid automatically redirecting users from one language version of the site to a different language version of the site, because this could affect your site's indexing. An alternative if you are using TranslatePress is to use their pop-up option to allow users to switch to their detected language. Otherwise, just let your audience choose their language using the language switcher. Though a feature that may seem good for your site visitors is not actually feasible for the search engines, at least for now, so just take note of it. Now, when you're doing manual translations, whenever you have links on your tags, for example this, they will need to be further reviewed. If this is an internal link, we recommend linking it to the same language version as the one you are translating. And if you are using WPML, this will be taken care of for you automatically. But if you want to change it manually, you can click on the unlock and change it, and save the link. Doing that, it helps search engines find translated pages easier, it enhances user navigation and experience, and as a result, improves SEO. And talking about internal links, we should also add a language switcher to your pages. I'm currently using the Bloxy theme, but any theme should work because WPML, TranslatePress, or any other translation plugins will provide that switcher. But for WPML, you will have to first go to its languages tab, scroll down a little, and you will see the language switcher options. You can adjust the order of languages here and set what happens if there are pages without translations. Then go to Appearance and select Menus. And then for this main menu, I want to add a language switcher. I'm pretty sure you have already created a menu for your site, so you are hooking the language switcher to the existing menu you have created. You will choose if it is going to be the first or the last item in the menu, choose if it is going to be a drop-down or a list of languages. Check this if you want to add flag to the language switcher, and then choose the color theme. And finally, click on Save. Now you have already added the language switcher to the menu. The next step is to ensure that the menu is added to your site. Head over to Appearance and visit the Theme Customizer, click on Header, and you want to make sure that the menu element is picking up the menu you have created. Let's close this to see the desktop version, and there you go. Make sure that if this is right, you want to click on Publish to save the changes. And now as you visit the page, you can toggle between English and French. Now, if you have added a schema markup on the English version of the page and you have translated it into another language, the schema markups may not be translated, and without proper settings, the schema markups will not be copied over. For example, I wish to translate this page, and if we go to Rank Maps tab and select the schema option, we have added the software schema here. And if we proceed to make the translation, let's do this quickly, and then let's visit the page editor. Let's go to the Rank Maps schema options, and we will see that the software schema is not added. So if we want to make everything seamless, what we need to do is to visit WPML settings, click on the custom fields translation. You want to scroll down and click on display all results to see all the custom fields of your site. You want to make sure that the rank map title is set to copy once, as well as the rank map description. But if you want to translate it directly from the WPML editor, you will select the translate option. The same goes for all the schema types over here. Personally, for the schema types, I prefer to translate it directly through RankMath. So I'll select the copy once option. And make sure to save changes. Now let's do another experiment. Let's create a new post and have the title as RankMath test. And then we want to add a software schema. And place the text in the pros and cons fields. Let's save for this post and click on publish. And now let's translate it. Once done, let's visit the page editor.
You see, this is the French version of the page. Let's check out the rank map schema, and we will see the software schema added. Let's check out the content, and we will see the text here. Now, to make sure that this is the French version, if we click on the link, we can see that this page is part of the FR subdirectory. So from here, whatever that is not translated, we can do it directly in the schema fields. Now, one more last best SEO practice for multilingual sites is to make your site load faster by using Content Delivery Network or CDN, because it helps deliver the content through the network that is closest to your audience. And that's all the best SEO practices. If you have any questions or suggestions, feel free to leave them in the comments down below. And don't forget to smash that thumbs up. Our channel is all about helping you grow your search traffic. So if you haven't subscribed to us, consider doing so. This is Jack from RankMath. I'll see you in the next video.